Hello, and welcome to the Correlation and Causation in SPSS workshop brought to you by the Graduate Statistics Studio here at Fresno State. Today we'll be talking about a very specific inferential analysis called the Pearson's R correlation coefficient. Now, Pearson's R is used for correlational studies. A correlational study is a study that has no manipulation of an independent variable, and so all it can really show you is a trend. Whereas an experiment has a manipulated independent variable, and so we want to see, is the effect of the independent variable affecting the dependent variable? So today we're going to focus strictly on correlational variables. So to talk a little bit about correlation, we first need to know about causation. So causation is knowing that one variable caused the results of another variable. For example, having two classes and randomly assigning one class to be taught with lecture only and the other class to be taught with lecture and group activities. The lecture and group activities class does better on the final exam than the lecture class only. So we know that the lecture and group activities class does better because we randomly assigned those students into the groups, and we see one group did better on the final exam than the other group. And that was because we manipulated our independent variable. We saw an effect from our independent variable on the dependent variable. Experiments can show causation because a variable is manipulated, like the example I just gave. However, in a correlational study, we can't show causation because there is no manipulated variable. Another example would be, instead of randomly assigning which class got the lecture, which one got the lecture and activity, we just looked at two already existing classes of those who had lecture and those who had lecture and activities, and we compared the results of the two classes. But we don't know if the lecture and activity caused one class to become better than the other class. It could be the teaching style. It could be the students in the class. There are a number of reasons that could have happened. So today, we're going to be focusing on Pearson's R correlation coefficient. Remember, no causation here. And we want to look at two variables. We have hourly wage and we have car loan. Both of these are quantitative measures. They're both measured on a scale. So what we want to determine is there a relationship between the hourly wage, the wage someone makes per hour, and how much they have left on their car loan? So what we might see is the more someone makes, the larger their car loan. We might see the more someone makes, the less they have on their car loan. Or we might see no relationship at all. But we'll use the Pearson's R to figure it out. Before we begin, I want to talk a little bit about what a quantitative variable is. A quantitative variable is a variable that is based on a scale. For example, a scale of 1 to 7, or negative 4 to 3, or 0 to 100. Here we have hourly wage. They could make nothing, or they could make a very large amount. And then we have car loan. They may have no car loan at all, or they may have a much larger car loan. It really depends. We can break up quantitative variables into two distinct types. We have continuous variables. Those are numbers that have decimals, or we can break them up into smaller pieces. We can see a continuous change over time. And we have discrete variables. These are the numbers that are whole numbers. For example, we don't have a half a person or a half an animal. We say there are three animals in the room or five people in the room. Never do we say five and a half. So counting people or animals is a discrete value, where a continuous value could be how much money you have in your bank account or how much do you owe on a car loan. Now we have qualitative variables, which is different from a quantitative variable. A qualitative variable is a variable where numbers only represent which group a set of cases are in. So a 1 doesn't mean 1 of something, it just means that's group 1. A 2 means that's group 2. And a 3 means that's group 3, and so on. The numbers don't have a ranking or anything. We could call it group square, triangle, and circle. It doesn't matter. It's just a way to represent that group. So let's move on with the actual analysis. We'll need to go to Analyze, Correlate, Bivariate. Bivariate meaning two variables. Bi meaning two and variate meaning variable. We get this window here, Bivariate Correlations. We want to bring hourly wage over to variables and car loan over to variables. We will be using Pearson's R correlation coefficient today, and we'll use a two-tailed test. We have options over here. We will want to include means and standard deviations, and that's pretty much it. We don't need to worry about style or bootstrap. And we have this checked, flag significant correlations. So that way SPSS will tell us which ones are significant, so we don't have to do any determination ourselves. But we still will. Once we press OK, we are brought to this window here. And we have our correlations, our descriptive statistics that we asked SPSS to analyze. The hourly wage mean was 16, and the standard deviation was 2.6. The average car loan was 14,000, with a standard deviation of 3,000. And there are 46 participants total. Down below, we have our correlations table. This is called a correlation matrix. Now, how we read this is we have hourly wage as one variable, and hourly wage is here as well, and we see the Pearson correlation is 1. Now, Pearson's R ranges from negative 1 to positive 1. The closer to 0 it is, the worse the relationship. The closer to plus 1 or negative 1, the stronger the relationship is. A positive value just indicates a positive relationship. A negative value just indicates a negative relationship. A positive relationship means that if one value goes up, the other value tends to also be up. And a negative relationship means if one value goes up, the other value tends to go low, or vice versa. So positive, the two values are both high together or both low together. Whereas a negative relationship, we see one value is low and the other one is high, or one value is high and the other one is low. Whereas zero represents no relationship. We don't see a trend at all. So it would make sense that hourly wage is perfectly correlated positively to itself, because every single number in its set is the same number. But when we look at hourly wage to car loan, we see the Pearson correlation is negative 0.715. So that's closer to negative 1, which tells us it's a strong negative relationship. And that tells us that as hourly wage is higher, the car loan tends to be lower. As hourly wage is lower, the car loan tends to be higher. Now, this could make sense because it's possible that if you make more money, you can pay off your car loan a lot sooner. Whereas if you don't make as much money, you will typically be settling with a longer loan amounts. So 6 years, 8 years, as opposed to something in 2 years. Now, if we look down at car loan, we see hourly wage, that same value. Now, in a correlation matrix, we see a mirror image. So this top triangle is a mirror image of this bottom triangle. If we had more variables, you could clearly see that. If we look at significance, our p-value, we see 0.000. Again, this p-value is not actually zero. It's just telling us that it's such a low number that when SPSS rounded up to 3 decimal places, it ended up being zero. We would not report our p-value as zero. We would report it as less than 0.05. And our n-value of 46. Now I want to show you what this relationship looks like, because I've talked about positive and negative relationships, but let's go a little more in depth. If we click on Graphs, Chart Builder. So here we have the SPSS Chart Builder. we want to click on scatter slash dot, and we want to select this one right here, simple scatter with fit line. We'll drag it up here. And so now SPSS wants to know what's the y-axis and what's the x-axis. It honestly doesn't matter which one we put there, so we'll just put hourly wage as our x-axis and car loan as our y-axis. When we press OK, so here we have our scatter plot that we just created. So we have hourly wage as our x-axis, and we have car loan as our y-axis. And we see this downward sloping trend. This line right here shows this negative relationship. It shows us that our values go down over time. Or as hourly wage goes up, our car loan goes down. But if we look at our hourly wage over here, we see our car loan tends to also be higher. So this is what I'm talking about when I'm talking about a negative relationship or a positive relationship. The closer to negative one or positive one, the closer each of these dots are to this line right here. The closer to zero a relationship is, these dots will be scattered all over the place. This line will be flatter, and it will be really hard to determine if there is a relationship or all. So that is the correlation and causation in SPSS Workshop. Thank you for joining.